We present our work on real-time sphere-sweeping stereo from multi-view fisheye images. Our goal is to build an imaging system capable of producing omnidirectional color and distance images. We were motivated to develop a device as affordable as possible, small and low power. Despite the requirements for relatively low power capabilities, we aim for real-time acquisition and processing. In recent years, omnidirectional RGBD imaging has been popular. For example, Komatsu et al. Present a low distortion representation, but it introduces a large computational burden. 360SDNet proposes a low-cost, two-view stereo approach. However, their camera layout does not show any exploitable baseline in the camera alignment. This data-driven method's performance is also limited by the availability of real-world datasets. Lastly, systems using a higher number of cameras can capture depth and color images with high accuracy, while increases the device's cost and computational requirements. In contrast, we focus on using 4 fisheye cameras, as it is a minimum number allowing the complete field of view to be covered by at least 2 cameras. Let's begin with defining the pupular geometry for spherical images. The idea is that a pixel at the reference camera 0 corresponds to a different sampling location camera 1 depending on the scene's distance. The sphere sweeping volume corresponds to the image captured by camera 1 and warped to the reference 0, following the sampling locations from different distance candidates. The color of the volume at the correct distance should be similar to the color in camera 0. Note that, unlike plane sweeping stereo, the volume is not built using homographies. When matching several spherical images to a reference, we observe that not all cameras show the same distance disambiguation. For this given configuration, the difference in distance shows no sampling displacement in camera 1, while the displacement is large in camera 2. As a large displacement is desired, we select, for each pixel, the camera that shows the maximum displacement. We show here the sweeping volume obtained with this approach. Each overlaid color represents a different selected camera for matching. We then compute the cost volume, which evaluates the matching quality between the sweeping volume and the reference image. Since the raw cost volume is noisy, cost aggregation is required. However, existing edge-preserving methods are too computationally expensive for our low-power hardware. To tackle this challenge, we designed a nonlinear filtering algorithm based on edge-aware downsampling and interscale bilateral upsampling. Here are results with different edge preservation parameters. The resulting filter shows a global kernel, and the method preserves edges while retaining optimal complexity and high parallelization. Using the regularized cost volume, we can select the best distance candidate accurately even in noisy or textureless region. At this point, we estimate the distance at 2 reference cameras. As they do not cover the entire field of view, they need to be stitched to create a complete panorama. The first step is to warp the distance maps to a reference viewpoint using Z-buffering. The new image naturally shows holes in the occluded regions. We want to fill the holes in a background to foreground manner. The green arrow shows the displacement direction of foreground objects. From this, we define a per pixel in painting kernel. This kernel can then be iteratively applied to fill the holes in an occlusion-aware manner. Once the distance maps are inpainted, they can be merged to cover the entire field of view. From 4 fisheye cameras, our method is able to estimate an omnidirectional distance map within 34 milliseconds on the embedded board. It also provides a high-resolution panorama. Here is our prototype capturing and estimating RGBD panoramas in real time. Our approach is able to estimate RGBD panoramas directly from fisheye images. It achieves 29 FPS on low-power hardware. As our study focuses on the algorithmic components, some hardware considerations have been left aside. For example, hardware synchronization and global shutter sensors could improve the accuracy when fast motion occurs. Thank you for your attention.